bang. She went and she wondered what had happened.
I was walking along. When something caught my eye. I stopped and said.
Down Villanasi again. But this time when she woke up an hour later, she knew what was happening.
Giraffe.
Anasi went back to Giraffe's house and made off with Giraffe. zebra was sitting on her porch. At her feet was a great pile of oranges. Anansi loved oranges, but was much too lazy to pick them up herself. So Zebra and Anansi went walking through the forest. After a while, Anansi led Zebra to a certain place. Bam! Down fell the Zebra. Anansi ran back to Zebra's house and made off with Zebra's oranges. An hour later, Zebra woke up. Her head was spinning. Anansi was nowhere in sight, and when Zebra got home, she found every single one of her bananas was gone. Oranges was gone. Zebra was sad, but Anansi was happy. She couldn't wait to play her trick again. So Anansi went walking through the forest until she came to Butterfly's house. Butterfly was sitting on her porch. At her feet was a great pile of blueberries. Anansi loved blueberries, but was much too lazy to pick them up herself. So Anansi and Butterfly went walking through the forest. After a while, Anansi led Butterfly to a certain place. Bam! Down fell Butterfly. Anansi ran back to Butterfly's house and made off with Butterfly's berries. An hour later, Butterfly woke up. Her head was spinning. Anansi was nowhere in sight, and when Butterfly got home, she found that every single one of her blueberries was gone. Butterfly was sad, but Anansi was very happy. She couldn't wait to play her trick again. Once more, Anansi went walking through the forest until she came to Panda's house. Panda was sitting on her porch. At her feet was a great pile of watermelons. Anansi loved watermelons, but was much too lazy to pick them up herself. So Panda and Anansi went walking through the forest. After a while, Anansi led Panda to a certain place. Down fell Panda. Anansi ran back to Panda's house and made off with Panda's watermelon. An hour later, Panda woke up. Her head was spinning. Anansi was nowhere in sight, and when Panda got home, she found that every single one of her watermelons was gone. Panda was sad. But all this time, watching from behind the leaves was Little Bushdeer. Little Bushdeer is small and shy and very hard to see. She watched Anansi play her wicked trick again and again on all the other animals. Little Bushdeer decided it was time for Anansi to learn a lesson. So Little Bushdeer went deep into the forest where the coconut trees grow. She climbed the coconut tree and threw down a great many coconuts. She carried the coconuts home in a basket and set them on her porch. Then she sat down beside them to wait. In a little while, along came Anansi. Anansi's eyes lit up when she saw Little Bushdeer's coconuts. Anansi loved coconuts. She loved to eat the tender white meat and drink the sweet coconut milk inside. But she was much too lazy to gather coconuts up herself.
Isn't it hot? It's very hot, Anansi. I'm going to go walk into the forest. Would you like to come? Yes, I would.
So Anansi and Little Bushdeer went walking in the forest. After a while, Anansi led Little Bushdeer to a certain place.
No, Anansi, I have not seen anything.
You must see it.
You must see it.
Look over here.
Look over here.
Wow.